And climate of the business world is changing at such a rapid pace that it is necessary to move forward swiftly in order to stay ahead. This is why it is necessary in business management to set out a plan that demonstrates the direction your company is headed in for a set time period. There are 20 principles of business management you need to learn and follow in order to be a successful business manager. So watch this full video, otherwise you will fail in your business. Number 1. Be energetic and enthusiastic. As a manager with enthusiasm and an optimist outlook, you will elevate those around you and energize your entire team. Adopting a can-do attitude and implementing enthusiasm in your day-to-day interactions will encourage others to look for a positive in even the most challenging situation presented. Number 2. Budgeting and forecasting. Budgeting and forecasting is all about setting goals for the future and tracking your progress towards the goals, which is typically through reporting actuals to budget and variance. Key budgeting and forecasting components include budget or forecast assumption, what-if scenarios, budget inputs and revisions. Number 3. Aim for perfection. As you define and establish value flow, wasteful processes will begin getting eliminated. Customer pool will be better addressed. All this will create a reorganization of processes across the organization, whereby more wasteful processes will become visible and the pursuit of perfection will be attainable. The end goal is always about adding value to the customer. Number 4. Identify the value chain. Value chain or stream is a set of activities throughout the organization that work on the product from the raw material stage to the finished good for the customer. Mapping and identifying each process in a chain helps in figuring out the logical order, wasteful processes, and in streamlining operations to deliver greatest value in the least amount of time. Number 5. Workflow. Workflow can be defined as a series of processes and procedures for the purpose of achieving a particular task or a function. In relation to business management systems, it is breaking down role and outcome-based tasks to sequential order, including the requirements at each stage. Here is an example of a sales-based workflow. Number 1. Lead qualification. Number 2. Opportunity identification. Number 3. Quotation. Number 4. Demonstration proof of concept. Number 5. Formal proposal. Number 6. Sign off. Number 7. Deliver a product or service. Number 8. Payment. Number 9. Follow up. Number 10. Support and maintenance. Principle number 6. Multidisciplinary in nature. Business management is a multidisciplinary in nature. Many of the principles and techniques used in management are borrowed from a number of other disciplines like psychology, sociology, economics, and mathematics. Number 7. Social process. Business management is a part of social process. Management achieves its objectives by with and through the people. It utilizes human resources for the achievements of organizational goals. Management has to consider not only the organizational objectives but also the social objectives. It has to fulfill the needs of employees within the organizational resources. Number 8. Respond to customer demand. An organization, production, and inventory process must be closely aligned with customer demand. Remember that cost of storing and transportation are ideal costs and do not add value to the product for the customer. Thus, understanding customer demand patterns better can help in improved production scheduling that can eliminate the huge wastage in terms of cost for storing excess products. Aim at producing what the customer wants when they want. Number 9. Create flow of value. Typically, only 5% of activities for a product or 50% of activities for a service add value. This waste, if removed, creates a flow that ensures that the product or service smoothly reaches the customer without delay, defect, and waiting. Number 10. Dynamic modifiable activity. Management is a dynamic and continuous process. The management system of today may not be applicable or effective for tomorrow. Therefore, management must be dynamic and flexible with the changing environment of the society. Management has to modify according to the time and situation. The flexibility is essential for an organization to adjust with the changing environment of the business. Number 11. Be a great communicator. Clean and concise communication is one of the most important managerial skills required. As a manager, you must be able to motivate, delegate, negotiate, pursue, analyze, and critique deals, tasks, and team members on a daily basis. Effective communication, whether written, verbal, or throughout digital media, are a skill required for any manager today. Number 12. Group activity. The concept of business management is not applicable if there is only one person or proprietor. It represents a team, class, or a section of people involved in various managerial functions. It is essential if there is a group of people involved in performing any activity to achieve common goals. Management defines the authority, responsibility, and procedures to perform specific work. Number 13. Distinct process. Management has a process involved various types of functions. One function of business management is interrelated with another function. The management clearly defines the specific process of work to achieve predetermined goal. It does not consider the trial or error approach. Number 14. Delegate effectively and efficiently. Being able to push critical tasks onto other team members isn't the answer to successful delegation. Instead, delegating to those most suited to the task, providing timely information and guidance, as well as consistently following up to ensure everyone understands the task at hand and the desired result, are key to effective and efficient delegation. Number 15. Goal-oriented. Every organization is established for a specific objective. Management is an instrument or a system that contributes for the efficient use of human and other resources to achieve predetermined objectives. The main objective of business management is to maximize productivity with optimum use of human effort. Number 16. Both science and art. Science is a systematized body of knowledge, principle, or truth that is experimentally proved. Similarly, art is the personal skill and ability to apply the scientific principles. Management is both science and art. It is a science because it is based on some basic principle of universal application. It is also an art because skill and ability is required for performing managerial function. Principle number 17. Be your team's biggest cheerleader and coach. Encourage your team throughout all stages of the game and offer coaching and guidance as needed during the process. A team is only as good as its leader and requires you to understand what is necessary to motivate the individuals to play at their best. In addition, continually recognize the successes of your team and encourage individuals to strive to improve on a continual basis. Number 18. Universal activity. Management is essential where human activity exists. The process of business management may be different from organization to organization, but the basic principles of management are same. It can said that the management principles are universally applicable. Number 19. Follow 10 business management skills. Number 1. Improve basic efficiency constantly. Number 2. Think as simply and directly as possible about your actions and why you are taking them. Number 3. Behave towards others as you would like them to behave towards you. Number 4. Evaluate each business and business opportunity as objectively and logically as you can. Number 5. Concentrate on what you are good at doing. Number 6. Ask questions all the time about your performance, your markets, your objectives. Number 7. Make money, because if you don't, you won't get the opportunity to do anything else. Number 8. Economize, because doing the most with the least is a valuable business management skill. Number 9. Flatten the company, so authority is shared by many people. And number 10. Admit your failings and weaknesses, because only then you will able to improve. Principle number 20. A profession. Profession involves the specific type of work followed by special knowledge and education. With the development of joint stock companies and multinational companies, the ownership and management has been different. Management of huge organizations has been entrusted in the hands of professionals having specific